In the Hunterian Museum, Lincoln's Inn Fields, London, among the strange exhibits, such as crocodile emerging from egg, and diseases of the spine, there is a great glass case. And in this great glass case, there is a skeleton of a man that has been standing there for more than 230 years. These are the bones of Charles Byrne, the Irish Giant.
Welcome to our little exhibition. He is a young man, only 21 years of age, but standing an enormous 8 foot 2 inches high, and then his ladies, in full proportion accordingly. Ladies and gentlemen, Charles Byrne, the Irish Giant! Hooray!
He was born in Ireland around 1761, to parents of normal stature. Said to have been 8 feet tall by his 19th birthday, he stood 8 feet 4 inches tall at the time of his death. Arriving in London in 1782, he quickly became one of the media's earliest celebrities, with accounts of his exploits appearing regularly in the newspapers of the day. According to an announcement of April 24th, 1783, he was
to be seen this and every day this week at the cane shop next door to the late Cox's Museum, Spring Gardens.
Most people were very kind, but there were those who preyed on the likes of Charles, the Irish Giant.
The Irish Giant, a few evenings since, taking a lunar ramble, was tempted to visit the Black Horse, a little public house facing the King's Mews, and before he returned to his own apartments, found himself a less man than he had been at the beginning of the evening by the loss of upwards of £700 in banknotes, which had been taken out of his pocket.
His savings stolen, poor Charles took to the drink. It was about this time that the Irish Giant attracted the attention of John Hunter, the eminent surgeon, possessor of the most extensive collection of anatomical specimens in the world. The thieves that night in the Black Horse had wanted to steal his money, but Hunter wanted something more. Hunter wanted Byrne's bones. In June 1783, at the age of 22, the Irish Giant lay dying at 12 Cockspur Street.
The whole tribe of surgeons surrounded his house, just as harpooners would an enormous whale. One of them has gone so far as to have a niche made for himself in the giant's coffin, in order to his being ready at hand on the witching time of night when churchyards yawn.
Byrne had left directions with some of his fellow countrymen to sink his remains with lead weights to the bottom of the Irish Sea, away from the clutches of the anatomists. But this was not to be. Somehow, the remains of the Irish Giant, along with one boot, his gloves and slippers, were obtained for the collection of John Hunter. Charles Byrne's bones remain on display to this day in the Hunterian Museum, the Royal College of Surgeons, London.